Well, good evening, good afternoon, whatever 5 o'clock is for you. We are so glad that you chose to come out tonight and be with us. 5 o'clock for the piano, worship through piano, and at 6 o'clock for our revival service. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. It is a privilege. If you did not get to meet Jacob Kluttz or hear him play pretty much a month and a half ago for our 100th anniversary, Jacob Kluttz is just a very talented piano player, self-taught. He loves the Lord, and it comes through in the way he plays. And this young man drove straight through the night from his parents' house in North Carolina to be here. I would worry about him falling asleep on the piano, but if you've seen him play, I don't think that's going to happen. So I think we'll be good. But Jacob, we appreciate you coming back. I'm going to open us up with prayer, and then I'm going to turn him loose, people. Tony, you think it's safe to turn him loose? All right, let's pray together. Father, we are so excited to be in your house tonight, Lord, and we know we have church family members and friends and neighbors here, and Lord, as we come here tonight, we have really one purpose, and it's to worship you. Some very unique ways to worship you, Lord, and as we listen to music played on the piano, and as Jacob leads us in this time of worship, I pray, Father, that this hour leading up to our service tonight will be something that you just be lifted up by. And Lord, I just pray for Jacob. I know he's worn out and he's tired. And Father, I just pray you give him the energy that he needs to do this next 45 minutes, God. And to you be all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Is my mic on? What a way to start. My last name is Kluttz, as all of you know. So we are going to try that one more time, less aggressively.
Thank you.
Y'all bear with me tonight. I drove a long way and my AC went out, and as y'all know, it's warm outside. But anyways, I am thrilled to be back here tonight. I can't even tell y'all how excited I am. I'm so excited I didn't even put my suit on to come out here. I just threw on whatever I could find, and here I am. But thank you guys so much for having me. Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate it. And it's an honor for me. It's been good to see some familiar faces. And I tell you what, you guys, this has become a family to me. And when Pastor called me and he said, you know, can you come back? And I said, well, have you lost your mind? I guess it's still there. And I said, absolutely, it's a no-brainer. So thank you guys again for having me. And I'm pulling out some old ones tonight that I hadn't done in a long time. I know that I've already done a decent amount for you guys. And so I'm trying to pull out some new ones so you don't have to have any repeats. But I'm going to repeat a couple of them tonight because they're just too good not to. Not for me, the song. But I want you guys to listen to this. This is just a praise and worship. I think you're going to like this. Y'all, I'm just trying to keep myself awake. I'm kidding. I'm not that tired. Well, I was going to try to find tissue. I'm going to grab one real quick. Like I said, my last name is Kluttz. And if y'all came for a professional, I just play the piano. That's all I do. But thank you guys for coming tonight. And I just wanted to share a little bit about myself very quickly. I know we're a little tight on time here. But I always make it an effort to share about myself and my testimony and why I do this. Because I don't know how many of you have heard me here. Oh. Well, most of you know my story. For those of you that don't know, my name is Jacob Kluttz, and I am self-taught on the piano. I've taught myself everything I know. And that is only by the grace of God, let me tell you that right now, because it's got nothing to do with me or anybody here on this earth. And I'm so grateful that God chose me, for whatever reason, this old sinner, to put at a piano and be able to travel around the United States and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ through music. Let me tell you what an honor that is for me. You guys have no idea. I love every minute of it. It wears me out. I drive long hours, sometimes with no air conditioning. And you know what? I wouldn't trade it for anything else. And I love it. And for those of you that don't know, I was adopted when I was 4 years old. I was born to a drug-addicted mother, adopted at the age of four by a couple from Salisbury, North Carolina, who just so happened to be, one was a music teacher, and my dad owns a grand piano company. You can't tell me God didn't know where he was putting me. And praise the Lord, because I've been through so many pianos. I'm not kidding either. But I'm just so grateful for his mercy and his love tonight and the grace that he's given me. That has been something that has been on my heart quite a lot recently, is God's grace. You know, I found myself recently in some trying situations and some scary times. And to be quite honest with you, I find myself complaining and getting upset and asking the Lord, why in the world are you putting these trials my way? I travel and I play the piano and I do it for you. Why are you giving me trials? And let me tell you what, I have seen more grace and more doors open through these trials than anything I've ever seen. And I think that it is God just showing me, this is what I can do. You think it's impossible, you just wait. I want you to see what I can bring you out of. And let me tell you what, he has brought me through so much, and I'm so grateful for that. And there's a song, and I wasn't going to play this tonight, and I played it the last time I was here. And I just feel like I should do it again. And it's my testimony from beginning to end. We serve a great, great God. Let me tell you what. I could go on and stand here and blab my mouth about everything he's done for me, and I know you guys could all do the same because we're sitting in here. I want you to listen to this. It's a very simple song, and we all know it. It just simply says how great thou art. Thank you. Now, I want you guys to see something, and I'm going to be done after this. I told you I've been all about God's grace lately, and let me tell you what, I came across this video, and I want you guys to see this tonight. I want you to listen to the story of Amazing Grace.
This has been an awesome night, isn't it, everyone? This one. How many of you like Negro spirituals? An old black lady down south showed me something about the Negro spirituals, and I want to share it with you. You know, the black folk down south had more sense by accident than some of us have on purpose, you know what I mean? You didn't hear what I said. I heard an old black lady say, "Son, if the mountain was smooth, you couldn't climb it." Think about that for a minute. But did you know, she said to me, "Did you know all, just about all Negro spirituals are written on the black notes of the piano?" This is absolutely true. You can go home tonight and play almost any Negro spiritual, just play the black notes on the piano. You look skeptical. Now, you can't see it out there, but I want you to watch. Watch. There are five black notes on the piano. And those same five black notes just keep recurring. You can go home tonight and play almost any Negro spiritual. Just play the black notes. Watch. You know that? Every time I feel the spirit, just black notes. Watch this. That's because the slaves didn't come to America with do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, di, do. That's somebody else's scale, okay? All they had in their musical scale were those five black notes. We know it in music as the pentatonic scale. And they built the power and pathos of the Negro spiritual on five notes. When you study music, you also come across what are known as white spirituals. Did you know that? And they are white composers who work with those that scale. In early America, they used to call this the slave scale. And I'm going to play for you what some musicologists think is the most famous white spiritual built on the slave scale or just the black notes. Anybody tonight know who wrote that song? I heard it, a man by the name of John Newton. But do you know what John Newton did before he became a Christian? He was the captain of a slave ship. And many believe heard this melody that sounds very much like a West African sorrow chant and wrote the words "Amazing Grace" and set his words to a slave melody. I looked up that song. I believe God wanted that song written just the way it was written, just so that we would be reminded that as Christians, whether black or white, free or bond, in his eyes, we're all connected. We are connected. And we are connected by God's amazing grace. We are connected by God's amazing grace. Woo! I looked up that song in the Library of Congress. I went to the Library of Congress. I looked up that song. And wherever you see it authentically printed, you know what it says? Words, John Newton. Melody, unknown. I tell the Lord, when I get to heaven, I want to meet Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, but boy, I want to meet that slave called unknown.
And we are just getting started. That's the good news. Jacob, we thank you so much for coming and being a part of our church family tonight. And I think we realize this is apparently this is just going to become what it is. When we have one of these Ardella Revival nights, we've just got to have Jacob. So we've already asked him to come back October 2nd when we have our final revival night of 2022. And so as long as he's not on the other side of America, we're not going to ask that boy to drive that car with no AC across America. But we thank you for being with us. And just, I think you will agree with me. There are very few times when you just feel the Holy Spirit coming through an instrument, but I think we have worshiped tonight through that piano and through Jacob, and so we are so thankful for that. I'm going to pray, and then in about 15 minutes, it'll give you time to go to the restroom, shake a few hands, look around and see who's with us. The kids, I think, are making their way out. They're going to do some games and stuff during this next service. But about 15 minutes, we're going to start our 6 o'clock worship time with Pastor Matt McGraw from First Baptist Bartow and our praise and worship team from Ardella. And it's just going to be a great continuation of God just tonight getting glory and receiving our worship and praise to him. So let's pray as we close out this portion of the service. God, I just know I'm so encouraged, Lord. And I know, Father, as believers, sometimes we just need to be filled. And Lord, you have filled us up tonight. Just seeing from where Jacob too has begun to what you are doing in his life. And Father, I pray in the years to come when you use him in mighty ways for your kingdom, that he remembers these middle-of-the-night rides with no air conditioning. And these seasons, Father, where things were a little bit more difficult, and he had to rely on you through some very tight times, because, Father, I believe those are the times that he will treasure in his ministry. I pray for his safety as he returns home tomorrow morning. And, God, we are just so grateful for that amazing grace and all of those hymns we sang tonight, just reminding us how much you love us, how important you are to us, and how important we are to you. So, Father, we thank you. And, Lord, in this next little bit, Father, as we fellowship with one another, I pray that that's an encouragement. And as we gather back together for an hour of worship, Father, it is our prayer that as we open up your word and study it tonight, that you equip us to be the children, that you equip us to be, as we talked about this morning, the ministers of reconciliation in this world. Be with us tonight. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. You're dismissed, and I'll see you in 15 minutes.